Let's talk about table tennis now. Let's talk about table tennis happening right here in the country, right, of the 13th. We're getting ready for the 13th ASO Table Tennis Annual Championship. And the chairman of the ASO Table Tennis Club, Dr. Olusegun Ajuwon, is appealing to the Ministry for Youth and Sport to support, that they need to support this sort of competition, because this is the place where new talents can be derived. At a news conference in Abuja, it says, look, we are not doing so well with table tennis at the club levels, at the schools. Yes, we have Aaron Okwodiri, we have Funke Oshanaike, we have Segun Toriola, but are we discovering new talents? And that's what they are saying, that too much attention on football, and we can actually do this for table tennis and win medals. Remember, table tennis gave the country a medal, two medals actually, at the just concluded Commonwealth Games in Gold Coast, Australia. So let's listen to Dr. Olusegun Ajuwon. We'll be right back.
The competition has grown in scope, as it is now. It has cadets, boys and girls, junior boys and girls, senior boys and girls, and the veterans. And who knows when it will go international. They say so far so good. These annual competitions have made modest contributions. We have identified and assisted in grooming some junior players that are currently national, African, and Commonwealth champions. For emphasis, let me once again appeal to the sports minister and the other public administrators to stop paying attention to only football to the detriment of the other sports. One Olympic gold medal in football is just one gold medal. Just as one gold medal won in weightlifting, table tennis, or swimming. Also, it is possible for a single sports person to win multiples of medals in these other sports. For example, Michael Phelps of UK won 8 gold medals for UK in 2008 Beijing Olympics.
So that's it. The chairman of the ASO Table Tennis Club saying, look, let's give more attention to table tennis. And I totally agree with him, because in the last 5, 6, even 7 years, it's been the same names that we've been talking about. And we'll talk about those names now, because Nigeria is competing at the World Team Table Tennis Championship. That one is being played in Sweden. Egypt, they are struggling, but Nigeria had a good start. Remember, Nigeria won their first and second game, defeated Turkey and Argentina. But today, for the first time, they tasted defeat in the hands of Slovakia. It could be described as a setback to their promotion ambition after they lost. Nigeria fielded the trio of Segun Toriola, Aaron Okwodiri, and Olajide Omotayo against the Slovakia's trio of Lubomir Pizdjej, Wang Yang, and Samuel Novata. It was Toriola that actually started, and he lost his first match by 3-0 to the hands of Pizdjej. Aaron Okwodiri restored parity. You see what I'll say? It's the same names that we saw feature in Gold Coast that are still competing right there in Sweden. So Nigeria, tomorrow, Wednesday, May the 2nd, they will confront Australia and Bulgaria, and they'll be hoping to determine their qualification to the knockout stage of the competition. For Egypt, the fight to remain in the championship division remains their main goal in Sweden, because Egypt, they have lost 4 matches in their group and they'll be walking a tightrope. So if you see all of the attention that has been given to Egypt and their table tennis, and they are struggling, little or no attention, and Nigerian table tennis players are doing so. So just imagine when we put attention into it, try and imagine what will come out of it. And customers, you can relate with that also. This is the same names over and over again. But it's good that at least with their talent, they're doing this, but more support. That's what we're saying, more support. Support might even mean what Funke Oshanaike is doing is supporting so that we can discover new talents.
And that is what I was telling you. I mean, when we were listening to the chairman of ASO Table Tennis Club talking, you know, when he talked about the fact that the sport ministry or the sport minister should give lots of support. I say, come on, the sport minister can't do everything. It's a very simple thing. The sport ministry should create that enabling environment for sport to thrive. Now, it involves providing sport facilities. There should be a structure. It's not as if there's no structure, but the structure is faulty when it comes to sports in Nigeria.
Maybe that's what they're talking about.
And work
with the federation. There should be a policy
that
everybody is working with.
There's a sport policy, in case nobody knows about that. There's a sport policy. But the question is this. What is the sport policy? Is the sport policy, does it create an enabling environment for sport to thrive in Nigeria? Give you an example. You just mentioned Funke Oshanaike. She just finished a competition recently. Yeah. Now, where did she do it? In Lagos.
Okay.
Now, I'm not blowing the trumpet of Lagos, but look at it. In the past over 8 years, Lagos have created the enabling environment for sport to thrive in Lagos State. By having centers, sports centers, there's Roe Park, there is the Agege Stadium, there is the Slim Balogun Stadium, that have facilities where sports can thrive. Now, they're building some places as well. And, you know, they're trying as much as possible to go to schools. Mm. And that is why Funke Oshanaike can come, make use of those sports structures, sports facilities, to make sure she does competition. Well, the sport ministry should do that. It's not everything the sport ministry will do.
Okay.
They need people to come in.
They should also monitor and then cut some of the bureaucracy so they can supply.
I agree, I get
where you're coming. Sports Tonight on China's television. So it's all about support and more support and trying to get better in ways that we can so that sports in Nigeria will thrive. Let's go on this break. When we come back, we'll not leave the grassroots. We'll talk about the first edition of the National Grassroots Sports Festival. Don't go anywhere. Stay.